What is the worst thing you have done to get revenge on someone? When I was 10, I murdered all my sister's Sims from the video game and printed out the photos and hid them in her room. She was still finding them months later. When I was in the 6th grade, someone made fun of me for being short, so I told my friend to pee on him. And he did it. My friend peed on the kid's back. That was a nice friend. 6th grade was weird for me. I worked for Lady Satan when I was a young single mom. She was completely abusive, but I desperately needed the money to provide for my daughter, so I had to stay. As soon as my student loan came in, I just quit coming into work without explanation, and after being a very reliable employee. That day was the day she was supposed to catch a flight from Mexico. She had to cancel her vacation so the store would stay open. I regret nothing. When I was a kid, there was a point in time that our entire house smelled like piss. Nothing could get rid of the smell. My mom is a neat freak who wants everything clean and smelling nice at all times. Eventually, when we were about to move out, my sister admitted whenever my mom would make her mad, she'd go piss in the vent. So much piss was in our vents that we had to get them professionally cleaned. My mom was so horrified she didn't even punish her for it. My brother wouldn't stop eating my food out of the fridge, so I got up really early, went to the shop, bought his favorite newspaper, and emailed him all the answers to the crossword so he wouldn't be able to do it on his lunch break. Sorry, but that's just how we roll in England. I cut her out of my life. I still own the house we bought. Really, I bought it on my credit. I kept her car. My name was on the loan and not hers. I made a bunch of new single friends, several of them gorgeous. And I am still friends with her family on Facebook, especially her brother. Dude is super cool and I enjoyed hanging out with him. I've paid down my debts, taken up golf, lost weight, and stayed single for over a year just to make sure I work through my issues so I don't take any of the crap I was left with into my next relationship. She had a new boyfriend 1 month after she moved out. She's living with her parents and struggling to make ends meet. Her family is absolutely furious with her because they loved me. They message me on Facebook regularly to check up on me. All of our mutual friends have stopped talking to her. Going through the divorce, I set aside my emotions. I packed and shipped her belongings out to her. I kept any emotion hidden from her throughout the process, and the day she left, I put her suitcases in her friend's car and said, "See ya," and then walked back into the house. My friends and family tell me all the time I should have tried to stick it to her, but honestly, I wanted to be rid of her. And I wanted to be proud of how I handled things. I am. I didn't do any of it despite her. Everything I have done is for me. The best revenge is to live well. See, the woman who lives with my cousin and I is... I can't really find a single word. She's manipulative, greedy, hateful, gossipy. I could go on, but I won't. The problem with her started when she began spreading some bullshit about how I made up weeks of cancer treatments and my girlfriend dying because I wanted attention. She would send extremely hateful text messages to me at random times of the day after I recovered from my depression, saying things like, "I should be ashamed of myself for lying to everybody," that my girlfriend never existed and that I used it as a cover-up because I'm secretly gay. I'd get these texts in class and it would be very difficult for me to continue going about my day after that. Why she would think or say those things to someone is beyond me, especially since she met my girlfriend at least once at a gathering at my aunt's house. Everyone knew she was real, so why bother? She still maintains I made all of that up to this day, 2 years later. That isn't all, either. Our bills were addressed to her until 6 months ago when I discovered she was dividing up the shares unequally and skimming money off the top of the money we gave her to cover it. She's broken into my room to have sex on my bed multiple times. She let her dog shit on my pillows. I've started dating someone within the past 2 months. I'm apparently paying her to have sex with me to keep hiding the fact that I'm apparently gay? Who would have thunk it? Anytime she fucks something up in the apartment, it is anybody's fault but hers. Case in point, our garbage disposal fucked up a couple months ago. Why? She peeled potatoes into it. There's a sticky note that resides on the wall above the switch to turn the disposal on, which states not to peel potatoes into the disposal. It's been there since the last time she clogged the disposal with potato peels. It was my fault, even though I hadn't been there in 3 days because I was visiting some friends. She's scamming her fiancé, plans to divorce him for all he's worth 5 years and 2 kids after they get married. He won't listen to anything I say because she has him wrapped around her little finger. How do I know this? Because she likes to gossip to her shitty friends on the phone about a whole lot of shit when she thinks nobody is around. Why don't we kick her out? Her parents own the condo. We pay rent directly to them. They think they've raised a perfect little angel and won't hear anything negative about her. Why don't I move out? I have nowhere to go. I can't afford it, so I just deal with it. Did I do something wrong when I put the hot sauce in one of her tampons? Undoubtedly. Do I care? Not really. Who am I to be judge and jury? I don't know. I had been wronged and I wanted revenge. I'm not really proud of what I did, but you better believe I'd do it again in a heartbeat. I hunted my mom's old boyfriend down in a deserted parking lot and beat him until his eye popped out. The beating lasted so long that I was physically out of breath at the end, and he was bleeding from his ears, nose, mouth, and eye. He smashed my skull when I was 11, and I spent a month in the hospital having my skull reconstructed. He got off easy. We were camping at my grandpa's farm, and he has donkeys that roam around the area, so naturally there were dried up old donkey turds laying around. My stepbrother was being an idiot and throwing some dried turds at me and my cousin. We warned him to stop, but he just kept chucking them at us, so I pinned him down while my cousin took a clump of donkey poop and shoved it in his mouth. My dad married a woman that had kids my age. One was a daughter that would get into my stuff and steal my clothes. She also had the largest collection of cassette tapes I'd ever seen, a whole double wall cabinet full of them. When my best blouse went missing, along with my new gym shorts, this was 1983 and I didn't have many clothes at all. I managed to lay my hands on a reel-to-reel magnet tape degausser. Was a 20-pound electromagnet, and I waited until no one was home, plugged it in, and ran it well across all of her tapes. The entire rack took 15 minutes to give the whole cabinet the thrice over. And a few days later, I hear complaining to one of her friends on the phone that her tape deck was not working, as none of her tapes were playing well anymore. My old boss was the worst human being I have ever had the displeasure to meet. A bunch of us collectively took revenge on him in different ways when we left. For reference, I worked at a small IT firm. We reported the business for massive amounts of software piracy. The accountant reported the company for tax evasion. Created a page for the company on jobvent.com and soon had 20 plus posts of venom directed at the boss. Sent anonymous letters to all of his clients informing them of his crooked business practices, overbilling, and horrible management skills. Someone used an old admin password to log into the old Unix web server, hosting all client websites and email, and ran a low-level format on it over a long weekend. The boss had let backups on that box slide. They were unable to recover anything. No idea who did that one. No one would take credit for it. When I was younger, there was a kid in my neighborhood about 5 years older than me that always used to pick on me and my buds. There wasn't much we could do considering he was about 200 pounds bigger than us. No joke. One day they were all over playing baseball when he asked for some water. I don't know what made me do it, considering I've never done anything like it before, but without hesitation, I grabbed the biggest cup we had in the cupboard, went into the bathroom, and scooped up water from the toilet. I still remember him slamming it down while holding the cup with two hands like little kids do. I thought that was pretty funny for little me to come up with. First time I found out my ex-wife was cheating on me. Yes, first time, there were several. I told the both of them flat out that it ends. She says, okay, but he tells me that I can't tell him what the fuck to do. I merely say, it would be better if you just left and broke contact. He says, fuck you. A week or so later, I found out Dingus is contacting her. I call him, tell him, it'd be a very good idea for you to stop now, again. Fuck you, in reply. He lived in a trailer house, of course. I grew up around them and had helped quite a few relatives deliver their new accommodations. Theoretically, while he was out to work a few days later, I could have climbed beneath his home, put air in the tires, pulled the four supports, and jacked up the front end. When he came home, it may or may not have gone down the hill and in the street. He may have gotten a ticket for that, the bill for the water spewing out, the raw sewage that had come out from it moving, and of course, the jacked up power lines. But that could be pretty intense, and even though all that happened to his trailer, I wouldn't want to claim any kind of responsibility. That would be wrong. Took a shit in a plastic bag and let it sit on the back porch for a week. Went back a week later, poop was dried up, and I crushed it up in the bag. If you've never done this before, it makes a powder. Bought a pack of the cigs he smoked and emptied one out, then filled it with the poop powder and packed it down with a pencil and replaced it in the pack. Then I waited. He tried to light it, inhaled, and threw up while driving.